So welcome back to your political science, everyone. Today this is the first session. Remember, there are three sessions are there today. Okay, so our major aim is to fulfill nearly 40 to 50% of the chapter executive. That's what the major aim today, major plan. Okay, so yesterday I only told you that we completed one chapter, that is election and representative system in India. Okay, so related with that, there are number of things are there in the chapter. First of all, why these elections? Okay, what are the different forms of election? Clear? First to pass the post system, the PR system, okay, proportional representation, and the countries, they are following the first to pass post system and the representative electoral system. Okay, next one, reservation for the seats, there. Okay, reservation system for SCs and STs and women, that was important. Next, we studied from that chapter is the election commission, the independent election commission, their functions and powers, of the election commission, that was important. And finally, we discussed that reforms that suggested in the elections by different political parties and the people. Okay, and that is under the consideration of the governments. Okay, such kind of things are too important from that chapter. So election and the election procedure. Okay, clear. So all those things we want to read one more time and learn that properly. So we are going to the fourth chapter today. It is executive. So tell me what you know about the executive. All you people are welcome to speak about that. Executive, tell me. So we'll start from A, right? Amal Raj, Amal, Ashish and Grishma, please turn on your camera. Ashish, Grishma Joshi, come on. Amal Raj, what do you know about the term executive? Tell me. So from junior classes onwards, you are listening these terms, right or not? In political science classes, means these three times the teachers will use. What is that? Legislature, executive, judiciary. Then tell me what is this executive? Organs of the government, right? Okay, all these three organs together we will call the government. Okay, government is not just the legislature, it is not just executive, or it is just not the judiciary. All these three organs of the government together we can call, the government of the country, right? Clear or not? So legislature have its own functions, executive has its own functions, and the judiciary have its own, right? My question is, you know about the legislature, we discussed already, the lawmaking body of any country, okay, it is basically termed as the legislature. So elections are related with the legislature, right? We are electing our representative to the legislative councils, okay, for the central legislative and the state legislative houses. Clear? Okay, that's what elections. Okay, clear. And the question is, what do you mean by the term executive and what are their powers? Come on, anyone? Amal Raj, I go ask you, Amal Raj, right? Amal, speak.
So it's a government, organ of government which make laws and policies, which are then followed by the legislature.
So listen one thing here. So lawmaking body, what is the lawmaking body? Out of these three organs, which organ is the lawmaking one? Is that executive or the legislature?
Legislature.
Ah, yes, of course. So all these things are connected with the rules and regulations, we know that. Okay, or administration, we know that. But a clear-cut distinction are there between these three organs of the government. So just to understand as a student of political science. Okay, if it is necessary, you can write and keep with you also, no problem. Should not make any mistake there. So the law making organ of the government is termed as the legislature. They are powerful to create the rules and regulations for the country, or able to make changes in the existing rules and regulations in the constitution. That is the legislature. Clear? Legislature. They are able to create the rules and regulations for the country or well-being of the people in the country. At the same time, they are able to make changes in the constitution, amend the constitution and its provisions. Clear? That's what executive for we people, sorry, legislature for we people. Okay, the law-making organ, the law-making body of the government, that's what the legislature, the first one, legislature. Okay, the law-making body. Next one. Executive, the main function of the executive is nothing but enforcing the rules and regulation. Enforcement. What do you mean enforcing? One rule is made, clear or not? And some or people we needed to observe whether these rules are following by the people or not, or breaching by the people or not. Clear or not? Okay, so it is the responsibility of the executive to enforce the rules and regulation. Enforce the rules and regulation. Enforcement. Okay, so example, one rule is made. Okay, smoking is prohibited in the public premises. Is that a rule? It's prohibited, right? Who will observe that? MLAs or MPs who created this law, they anyway, they will not come to the public premises to check whether people are following these rules or regulations or not. Anyway, they won't come, right? Yes or no? Then for that, special departments are there. Okay. Even the police department, other departments under the control of the government are able to observe whether people are accepted this law or they are rejected or not. Different departments are there. If people are not accepting it, the responsibility of the executive to make them accept it, or creating the situation where people should not or people will not breach or break such kind of rules and regulation. That's what the executive. Clear? So executive are of two types. What are they? What are they? They are the permanent executive and the political executive. The permanent executive and the political executive. From the elected members in the legislature, the majority party will choose the ministers for different departments or ministers for different affairs. We know that, right? Only the ruling party or the ruling coalition, they will choose the council of ministers. They will prepare the council of ministers where we are unable to find out the members of other party in that. Clear? Example, BJP's ruling means all the ministers from that party only. Clear? Congress is ruling means all ministers from that party only, or there are supporters or alliance parties, allied parties. Okay, clear or not? That's it. So that's what this politic, that this ministers or the council of ministers is basically termed as the council of the executive. What kind of executive? The political executive. Political executive under the chairmanship or the head control of the prime minister in India. In we can say. In India, we are following the parliamentary system, right? So, the Prime Minister is the head of that Council of Ministers, right? Clear or not? So, they are termed as the political executive, because political executive will change in after all the elections, right? Right or not? Continuously, they will not stay for a long period of time. The maximum tenure is 5 years. Okay. Again, that party ruling means my chances are there for that people to continue for the next time also. But commonly, it will not happen. Right or not? Clear. It will change related with the tenure of the government. One tenure finished, next political executive will come into power there. The ministers will change. Clear? That's why we are using this term, political executive. They are not permanent. Okay, but at the same time, another set is called to be the permanent executive. Now you got what you mean the permanent executive, right? Who are they? Who are the members of the permanent executive? An idea?
The officers.
Of course. Yeah, of course. Okay. The civil servants, okay, the government officials, the bureaucrats are considered as the permanent executive. Permanent executive. Why they are called to be the permanent executive? What is the reason behind that? Because they are selected or not elected. Rare. They are not elected by the people, right or not? They got the job by completing examinations clearing UPS examinations, state examinations, like that various examinations they're clearing and become the civil servants, right or not? Clear? So their tenure is not for 5 years or something like that. Retirement age is fixed by different governments, right? Retirement age, that's what. Up to that particular age, they will remain in their post. Okay, in some cases, the government have the power to dismiss or suspend them. That is another thing. We are not discussing about that. Anyway, they will continue up to that particular term. Okay, the age of retirement. Up to that, they will be on in that particular post. Clear? Clear or not? Okay, so that we will use the term permanent executive. Permanent executive. So legislature is the lawmaking body. Executive is the law enforcing body. So ministers are considering as the political executive, and the bureaucrats is termed as, or the civil servants are termed as the permanent executive. Permanent executive. Hope these ideas are clear. Right. Okay. Next one, judiciary. What is the role of judiciary? We want to learn that too, right? What is the role of judiciary?
Checks the law.
Ah, so we know that Legislature is the body. Basically, they are creating rules and regulations, right? Legislature. Next one, it is executive. Their main aim is to enforcing the rules and regulation. Enforcement. Clear? So, legislature, maybe the state legislature or the central legislature, their main idea is to make rules for the welfare of the people. So, already we studied in the second chapter, what that directive principles of the state policy. So, the government, I mean, the legislature have the powers to create rules and regulations for the well-being of the people. Okay, the constitution says that, right? What did that constitution says? It is the responsibility of the government to create such kind of rules and regulations or provisions for the well-being or development of the individual citizens in the country. Clear? Yes or no? As per the Indian Constitution. Indian Constitution. So, legislature, it's a body of organ of the government that creating rules and regulations, or even they have the powers to amend, make changes in the Constitution. Amendment. Okay. Write the term amendment. What is that? Amendment. What do you mean by the term amendment? Amendment. Elvina? Already
Change.
told that. Making changes in the Constitution. Or altering the rules and regulations that existing in the constitution is considering as amendment. Okay, what is that? Amendment. Clear? Okay, so just always we'll use the term related with the constitution only. If the legislature is making any changes in the present rules and regulation or altering that, we can say that it is amended. The constitution is amended. Why amendment is necessary? Why amendment is necessary? So we know that. Can anyone tell me why it is important? Amendments are important. Can anybody?
People request change when, like, for in case of technology,
Very good.
different changes have come, so there have to be laws enforced.
Definitely. Okay. So we know that related with the time, we are able to find various changes in the society, right? Number of different changes we are able to observe in the society. So if the existing laws or rules or regulations are not enough, okay, or it is not sufficient, we want to make changes in the constitution, right? That's what amendment. That's what a amendment. Clear? Making changes in the constitution. For example, we know that in today's world we are using different electronic gadgets, okay, and social medias, okay, more than any printed media, more than any, what we can say, a mass media. Today we can say that, okay, electronic medias are basically conquering the world. Electronic medias like Twitter, Facebook, WhatsApp, like that number of different platforms are there, basically spreading these news, circulating the news for communication also, clear or not. But if you are observing the Indian Constitution that formed before 50 to 60 years, okay, or 70 years, we cannot see such kind of rules and regulations that prohibiting the bad use of or wrong use of this electronic media. We are unable to find. Clear or not? But that is today's invention, okay, and today's activities, okay. So we want to add such kind of rules and regulations in the present constitution. We want to make rules and regulations to protect the people from mishandling of this kind of electronic media. Clear? That's what amendment is necessary. So it is the responsibility of the legislature. Write on responsibility of the legislature. So three organs are for the government. One is the legislature. Next one it is the executive, and the third one it is the judiciary. Clear? Clear. That's what the last chapter we discussed about the different types of elections to choose our representatives to the legislature. What are they? What are the two types? What are the two systems? Anybody? Tell me, Elvina, what are the two systems for election?
First past the post and
First
proportional
past the post and the proportional
representation.
representation. Proportional representation are the two methods what we are using in India. But first past the post is generally accepted by the people. Okay, because India is a vast country, so that system is considering as the suitable system for election in India. Okay, but for electing the members, I mean electing the president, vice president, okay, we are using that PR system also. Okay, proportional representation. Proportional representation, basically it is for indirect elections we are using in India. That last chapter we discussed, that is all about the legislature. So in this chapter basically we are discussing about executive, only executive, right? Clear or not? So executive means the second organ of the government. So all these three organs are basically, we can say that it's in watertight compartments. Clear or not? Legislature will not observe or interfere in the activities of the executive or judiciary. Clear? Executive will not interfere in the activity of the legislature or the judiciary, like the judiciary will not interfere also, I mean, the activities of the legislature and the executive. All these things, three organs are independent. Okay, special powers are there, special functions are there. So executive, coming to executive, we know that we are able to classify the executive into two categories. Two categories. Junior classes, you already studied that. I already told you that. What is that? Two are there. One is the permanent executive. Other one is the political executive. Political executive. Write down. The permanent executive and the political executive. The permanent executive and the political executive. Ashish, when you please turn on your camera. Ashish. Okay, political executive and the permanent executive. Okay, so political executive means the council of ministers. Clear? So, we are conducting election to elect our representatives to the legislature. If from the legislature, the majority party will make the government and hold the power. All right. So obviously we can say that as per this first past post system, okay, the ruling party will create the council of ministers only with the members from that particular political party. Clear? The party who win majority seats in the country. Clear or not? Okay. Yes or no? Is that idea clear? Okay. So political executive from that particular party. So every 5 years the political executive will change. We know that because of elections. The tenure for one government, is 5 years in India. So we can say that this political executive, the council of ministers along with the prime minister, okay, chances are there they will change. Clear? Sometime may not change also. Okay, the same party continuing means the prime minister won't change. But 99% we can say that the changes will be there. Changes will be there. Okay, so far we not observed any council of ministers without any changes after the elections. After the elections there. That's what the Indian political history says. Clear? Okay, next one. It's called to be the permanent executive. Permanent executive. What is the importance of permanent executive? Who are they? We know that. They are the government officers. Write down. The government officers, the civil servants. Civil servants. Okay. They will remain in the post up to the age of retirement, right? Age of retirement. So different government, we know that different ages are there at fixed as age of retirement. Okay. In between 58 to 60. Clear? Age of retirements are there in a different state governments and the central governments also fixed. So that is 58 to 60. Clear? But for some other offices, example, you can see that in the case of election commission, okay, if it is appointed by the government, that tenure it is up to 65. Up to age of 65, the chief election commission can stay in that particular post. That is another thing. So variations are there related with this age for retirement. Okay. Sorry, everyone. Okay, so keep that idea in your mind. Okay. Up to this, clear or not? Okay, now we want to discuss about the functions of executive. Why this executive? What is the reason behind it? What are the functions of executive? So for simple understanding. So legislature is the law making body, right? We know that. Okay, so what the executive will do? Grishma, tell me Grishma. What is the function of the executive? What is the responsibility of the executive? Can you hear me, Grishma?
The executive ensures that the laws made by the legislature.
Definitely, correct. Okay. It is the responsibility of the executive to enforce the law that made by the legislature. Enforcing the law. Okay. Here, the ministers are there, right? They are the considering as the political executive head of different departments. Okay. Different affairs are there under the control of these ministers. Okay, so all the department staffs also under their control, and this basically the political and permanent executive together will enforce the law. They will observe. Okay, if anyone breach the law or break the law, it's the responsibility of the executive to take them in front of tell me,
judiciary.
Yeah, of course, judiciary. So executive don't have the power to punish. Clear? It is their responsibility to bring them and present them in front of the court. So here comes the third organ of the government. What is that? The judiciary, the judicial system. Okay, from class 8 onwards you are learning that, right? Not onwards, but I can say only 8th class, some preferences are there. Okay, right or not? References are there for related with this judicial system. In class 9 and 10, there is no such references. Okay, only about the constitution, class 9 speaks. Okay, and class 10, no, we are unable to find anything related with the constitution. Again, in class 11 only, related with this judicial system, we are learning something. Okay, so judiciary, we know that what is their role in the government, the third organ of the government, right? Come on, tell me. What's their function? What's the function of judiciary?
They checks the law and punishes the people who breaks them.
Of course, it is their responsibility to punish the people, those who break or the breach the law, right? Okay, not just giving the punishment, but only after a fair trial. Fair trial, right? After the fair trial only, the judiciary can give the punishment for the people there. Okay, so hope the base of the chapter is okay for you people, right? Now you know about what is the legislature, what is executive, and what is judiciary, and their powers and functions there. Okay, so just use this time to recall all the idea what we learned in the previous classes. Now we are moving to the chapter directly, executive, chapter number 4 here for us. Okay, what is an executive? The first question, clear? Who is in charge of the administration of your school? Who takes important decision in a school or a university? Two questions are there, right? So easily we are able to say that. Who is in charge of the administration? In charge of administration. The executive, right? Right or not? Okay. In any organization, some office holder has to take decisions and implement those decisions. We call this activity administration or management. Underline that. So, in any organization or in every organization, some office holders will be there to take the decisions and implement those decisions. Okay. To compare with the government institutions, we can say that they will take the decisions and implement the decisions only within the framework of the Indian Constitution. Only within the framework of the Indian Constitution. What do you mean by that? Within the framework of Indian Constitution, no association or no organization or no government institution in our country can take any decision than or out of the concept of the Constitution, right? So always they have to take a decision within the framework of the Constitution. Okay, what is there in the Constitution? What procedures are there in the Constitution? All the government institutions want to follow the same. Nothing more than that, or nothing less than that. Clear? Exactly, directly, what is observed in the Constitution, they have to follow the same. Clear? Next one. But administration require a body at the top that will take policy decision or the big decisions and supervise and coordinate the routine administrative functioning. You may have underlined that all. You may have heard about the executive of big companies, banks or industrial units. Every formal group has a body of these whom function as a chief administrator. So, executive is a body of chief administrators. Okay, body of chief administrators. Some office holders decide the policies and rules and regulations and then some office holders implement those decisions, actual day-to-day functioning of the organization. The word executive means a body of persons, underline, the word executive means a body of persons that looks after the implementation of rules and regulation in actual practice. So, come back to our system. Okay, legislature, executive and judiciary. For example, the legislature that made a law. What is that law? Smoking is prohibited in the public premises. Clear? But the people, those who made that law, I mean our representatives or MLS or MPs who created that law, okay, they will not or they don't have the power to observe whether people are accepting it or they breach that. Cannot do that. Okay. So here comes the importance of executive. It's their responsibility to observe whether people are accepted it, they are following it or not. Clear? If it is not so, it is their responsibility to take them before the court. Clear? For example, police department, right? They can do that. They have the right. But police department don't have the power to punish the people. Are you thinking so? Not at all, right? Not at all. Only judiciary can do that. Judiciary can do that. So all these organs are, I already told you that in watertight compartments, there is no relation between one to another, right? Okay. So moving forward. Are you able to see the screen? Hello?
Sir.
Yeah. So here, in the case of government also, one body may take policy decisions and decide about rules and regulations, while the other one would be in charge of implementing those rules. Now you got legislature and executive, right? Okay. The organ of the government that primarily looks after the function of implementation and administration is called the executive. Underline again. The organ of the government that primarily looks after the function of the implementation and administration. It is called the executive. It is called the executive. Okay, next question. What are the principal functions of the executive? It's an important question for the examination. The most important functions of the executive. Okay, so it's entire is an answer for the question. What are the principal function of the executive? Just learn it properly, understand that properly. So executive is a branch of government responsible for the implementation of laws and policies adopted by the legislature. Clear? No doubt in that, right? You already observed. The executive is often involved in framing of policy. Underline. The executive is often involved in framing of policy. How to enforce the rules and regulation? Okay, it is up to executive. Executive will form the policy. Clear or not? Okay, only executive, the council of ministers and the bureaucrats. The executive is often involved in framing policy. The official designations of the executive vary from country to country. Okay, so in different countries, the designation of executives, it is different. Some countries have the presidential system, while others have chancellors. Okay, example, for Germany, it is the German chancellor. A question for you, who is the present German chancellor? An idea? Who is the present German Chancellor? Ajay, who is the present Prime Minister of our country, India? Ashish, who is our Prime Minister? Can you hear me, Ashish? Connectivity trouble, I think so. So, write down, who is the present? Chancellor of Germany.
Sir, okay, so,
what, Amal?
Sir, can I get the answer?
Tell me.
Sir, Angela Merkel.
Angela Merkel, correct answer. Okay, Angela Merkel. Okay. So, Ashish Bini, I am appreciating you. Okay, for this wonderful answer, because some people, those who have the connection with the newspaper or the news, can say that answer. Okay, Angela Merkel, correct. So, using the term newspaper, repeating newspaper. Okay. For a political science student, it is too compulsory and it is necessary. The newspaper. Not just any paper, okay, but we want to read or we want to compare the news in different newspapers. That is another thing. Okay, so example, some newspapers are biased papers. What do you mean biased papers? They will write their own aspects, their own interest. Okay, reality will not be there in that. Okay, so we cannot blindly believe the news in such kind of papers there. Okay, just keep that in your mind. So in different countries, different political systems are there. Okay, the executives have different designations. Some call it as a prime minister, some call it as a chancellor, some call it their president. Okay, so the executive branch is not just about presidents, prime ministers and ministers. It is also extended to the administrative machinery, the civil servants. Not only the presidents, not only the prime ministers or chancellors, who are included the missionary, the government missionary, like the civil servants also included in that. While the head of the government and their ministers saddled with the overall responsibility of the government policy. Saddled means they are controlling that. Okay, clear? Okay, the control is with them, that's what. While the head of the government and their ministers saddled with the overall responsibility of the government policy. If the police department is committing any mistake or a crime or a trouble in the society, basically we will say it is the problem of the government, right? The government did it, right or not? Not the police or that individual did it, but the government did it. Yes or no? almost all the time we will use that term there. So if the police department or the executive or members of the executive, if they are creating any trouble in the society, definitely the government is responsible for that. It is the government. We'll speak that. Okay. Just keep that idea in your mind. Okay. Next one. Here, while other have chanceless, sorry, completed, are together known as the political executive, those responsibilities for this. Are together known as the political executive. Those responsible for day-to-day administration are called the permanent executive. Those responsible for day-to-day administration, they are called to be the permanent executive, the civil servants, basically. Clear? Okay. Give me a moment. Next question, what are the different types of executive? Different types of executive. What are they? Here you can see that a presidential system and a parliamentary system. Presidential system and a parliamentary system. One more system is called to be the semi-presidential system. Semi-presidential system. Okay, so every country. So yesterday, those who read the newspaper, yesterday there was a news in America. Read that? There is a controversy is going on there, right? There's a trouble is going on there between the ruling party and the opposition, right? Clear? Right. Every country may not have the same type of executive. You may have heard about the president of the USA and the queen of England. Clear? President of United States of America and the queen of England. Queen of England. But the powers and functions of the president of USA are very different from the powers of the president of India. Clear? In India also president is there, but the powers are different. Powers are different. Similarly, the powers of Queen of England are different from the powers of the King of Nepal. Different. Okay. Both India and France have prime ministers, but their roles are different from each other. Why is this so? What is the reason behind this kind of differences? Number of reasons are there. Right? Clear. So, first of all, you want to understand that basically there are three types of governmental system or executive systems are there. One is headed with the president, other is headed with the queen, other is headed with the prime minister. Okay, some countries are having the semi-presidential system. Like that, various systems are there. Okay, activity. So, procure a photograph of the SAARC summit meeting of the meeting of G8 countries and the list of those who attended the meeting. Can you imagine? Why those people and not some others are attending the meeting? Okay, so different world leaders will attend the meetings there, right or not? So if you're observing the news related with the UN conferences, we are able to find the head of different countries there and their designations. So we can say that American president is the world powerful person, right? The most powerful person in the world. Most of the newspapers will give this a glorification. Okay, I use this term glorification because reasons are there. I will say that later. Okay, so the American president, the most powerful person in the world, it seems. Almost all the newspapers will glorify that. Because the military is that powerful, that's what. Clear? The military of that country is that powerful. Nuclear weapons are there with them. And all these nuclear weapons and its security code is safe with the president of the United States of America. So he can control it. That's it. That's why we are using the name what he is the most powerful person in the world. It seems there. Okay. The most powerful government. Okay. To answer the question, we will briefly outline the nature of executive existing in the some of the countries. The United States of America has a presidential system, and executive powers are in the hands of the president. Canada has a parliamentary democracy with a constitutional monarchy where Queen Elizabeth II is the formal chief of the state and the prime minister is the head of the government. Clear? Underline that. So the USA has a presidential system and executive powers are in the hands of the president. So executive powers are with the hands of the president. So not only making the rules, enforcing the rules also under the control of the president. He is the last and final word. So Canada has a parliamentary democracy with a constitutional monarchy where Queen Elizabeth II is the formal chief of the state. Okay, so it's not Canada, Britain. Okay, so in Britain is there following the parliamentary democracy with a constitutional monarchy where Queen Elizabeth II is the formal chief of the state and the prime minister is the head of the government. That is in Britain, not in Canada. Rewrite that. Okay, what is the speciality in Britain? There is a parliamentary system is there. Two houses are there for the government. The same time they are following the constitutional monarchy also. Constitutional monarchy where the prime minister is the powerful one. Okay, here Queen Elizabeth II is the formal chief of the state and prime minister is the head of the government. Chief of the country and head of the government, both are different. Clear? Only the head of the government can participate functioning the decision or enforcing the decisions. Clear? In France, both the president and the prime minister are the part of the semi-presidential system. Almost the same powers are there. So it is called to be the semi-presidential system. France is an example for a semi-presidential system. President is there and the prime minister also. Okay. Here, the president appoints the prime minister as well as the ministers but cannot dismiss them as they are responsible to the parliament. Okay. The president is appointing them but cannot dismiss them. Japan has a parliamentary system with the emperor as the head of the state and the prime minister as the head of the government. Underline that. Japan. Another system. Okay, they are also following a system there. Prime minister at the head of the government. Clear? And emperor is the head of the state. Emperor is the head of the country and the prime minister is the head of the government. Next one, Italy. Italy has a parliamentary system. Okay, so we will discuss in the next class. Okay, guys, the time up. Again, today one more period is there in 145. Already Sarah informed you people, right? 145. Okay, fine. Thank you.